Hello everyone, welcome to Coaster Hour, and today I will be ranking my top 10 favorite parks I've visited. Keep in mind that this is all my opinion, and when ranking these, I thought of how much I've enjoyed the park during my visits, and not necessarily which ones are objectively the best. With all that said, let's get right into this countdown. Starting us off at number 10 is a park that I consider an absolute classic, the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk. Now, not every park out there has to have elaborate theming or a world-class lineup of roller coasters to be fun, and that is certainly the case for the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk. It is a fun small park by the sea with a lot of charm and some fun rides, including the legendary Giant Dipper, which is one of my all-time favorite wooden coasters. I also have some great memories there, as I won over 1,200 tickets at the arcade when I was a lot younger, just off of one game alone. And I have had many terrific rides on the Giant Dipper, and my night rides on it are certainly among the best night rides I've had on any coaster, period. The boardwalk, while not amazing, is still an awesome place to go for a few hours of fun, and if you're in Santa Cruz, I highly recommend you visit the boardwalk. Heading over to Anaheim, California, we get to my number 9 park, which is Disney's California Adventure. And while this park isn't my all-time favorite or anything, there are still some great things about this park overall. Cars Land is amazingly themed, and as a little kid, I actually loved the Cars film, and so for me, this is easily my favorite section of the park, as you really feel like you're walking around Radiator Springs. Also, the main attraction of the area, Radiator Springs Racers, is an insanely fun and immersive dark or car ride experience that is just absolutely amazing. The other two standout attractions for me is Incredicoaster, which is a very fun family launch coaster by Intamin, and Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, which is easily the most thrilling and intense ride in the entire Disneyland Resort, and is an absolute blast every time. The Num Num Cookies by Incredicoaster are also absolutely delicious, and the food options at the park are pretty decent. I just wish that there were more highlight attractions at this park, and I think that California Adventure is going to improve a lot with the new Marvel-themed land that should help the park get out of its weird state, as it's going through a bit of a transition right now. But overall, Disney's California Adventure is a great park, and it definitely deserves to be on this list, and that is why it comes in at number 9. At number 8, I have Disneyland California, located next door to the California Adventure, and to be honest, I didn't really know where to put Disneyland since I actually haven't visited the park in over 6 years, so I went pretty conservative for its spot because yes, I did enjoy it, but that was over 6 years ago. And because of that, I think this park could rise a lot in my rankings the next time I visit, as the park has amazing theming, as well as a lot of great rides such as Matterhorn, Space Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain Railroad, Pirates of the Caribbean, and many others, and they also have pretty nice staff, and the food there was pretty good, especially considering it was from a theme park from what I remember, and with Star Wars Galaxy's Edge recently opening, you can definitely bet that I'll be coming back to Disneyland, as it is a fantastic park that I cannot wait to revisit. California's Great American Santa Clara comes in at number 7 and is my favorite amusement park in Northern California. This park, while somewhat small, is well run, clean, has pretty good operations, and does exactly what you would expect from a good park. It also looks pretty nice and has some great coasters such as Flight Deck, the B&M Invert, Gold Striker, the GCI Wooden Coaster, and Railblazer, the RMC Raptor, that is in my top 10 coasters overall. It also appears that Great America is only going to get better with the 20-year plan Cedar Fair has with it that'll improve the park with better rides and a new entrance area, and I cannot wait to see how much this park improves. As of now, while a good park, I don't really think that Great America is in any way really spectacular, which keeps it from being any higher on my list, but if you go to Northern California and you can only visit one theme or amusement park, I'd easily say that California's Great America is your best option. Down in Mexico City, we find a park that not too many coaster enthusiasts or people from the US have visited, and that is Six Flags Mexico. In my opinion, out of the 3 Six Flags parks I've been to, this one is the cleanest, nicest looking, and it also has the best food. The Mexican buildings that are vibrantly colored look really cool, and the food options here, while mostly typical for Six Flags parks, they do have authentic Mexican food, which for me and my family is a huge plus. Also, some of the rides here have some actually well-themed and crazy queues, which is completely unexpected coming from Six Flags, and while the coaster collection could definitely be improved, the top two alone are definitely worth coming for. Medusa Steel Coaster and Superman El Ultimo Escape are world-class coasters that both give different but awesome experiences. The few downsides of the park is that during the off-season, they just only run one train on many of the coasters, and there still is a lot of advertisements, as this is a Six Flags park. But even with that, I highly recommend this park if you are going to visit Mexico City, and it certainly earns a number 6 spot on the list. Now, coming in at number 5 is a park I used to not really like a whole lot, but after a visit in 2018, my opinion definitely changed, and for my number 5 spot, I have Universal Studios Hollywood. Yeah, this one is probably a shocker, but compared to the other parks I've visited, Universal is extremely unique. The highlight area of the park is definitely the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, which looks absolutely incredible, and has some cool shows, well-done interactive areas, and solid food, and this is coming from someone who hasn't even read the Harry Potter books. Also, the best rides here are really something else. The Forbidden Journey is the best dark ride I've ever ridden, hands down, and it uses Hogwarts Castle as its queue, which once again looks phenomenal on both the outside and inside. The other incredible ride or attraction is the Studio Tour, which is an absolute must-do if you go to Universal Studios Hollywood, as it can't be found anywhere else, and you get to see where the shows and movies are filmed, with a few other awesome surprises. Revenge of the Mummy is also a great indoor launch coaster that you will definitely want to ride, and the shows are also superb, with Waterworld being exceptionally good, and if you had to just watch one show, you should definitely go see Waterworld. So Universal Studios Hollywood, while not really having many coasters, is still a great park that serves more as a great overall experience, and because of that, Universal is one of my favorites. Number 4 on the list is the park that I consider my home park, and that is Six Flags Magic Mountain. Now this park definitely has its flaws. It could look nicer, it could have better food, the staff could be better, I could go on, but since this is my favorite parks list, I'll focus on the real positive and why I like Six Flags Magic Mountain so much, which is its coaster collection, which is absolutely phenomenal and easily the second best of any park I visited. You have X2, which is a Aero fourth dimension coaster that is just super intense, super crazy. You have Twisted Colossus, the RMC hybrid coaster that duels, has great airtime and great inversions. Tatsu, which is my favorite B&M coaster, and a terrific flying coaster, really intense also. You also have Full Throttle, which is a really fun premier launch coaster, and there are also many other great coasters and rides at the park. Also, the view of the park from the highway is just awesome, as you can see so many huge rides and amazing coasters. The park almost looks unreal. Obviously, if you're a coaster enthusiast, you absolutely must visit this park, as besides Cedar Point, I don't think there's another park with a better coaster collection, and that is why it makes it at number 4 on the list. Knott's Berry Farm is my number 3 park, and this place is just really awesome, and I think that anyone could have a good time here. The food here is extremely good for a theme park, and the ghost town is also pretty immersive and well-themed, which makes Knott's, to me at least, more of a theme park rather than an amusement park. Knott's also has some of the best coasters in California, with Accelerator, Ghost Rider, and Hang Time, which I have yet to ride. They also have my favorite log flume of all time, with the Timber Mountain log ride that has animatronics and is just a great ride overall. For me though, the best time to visit Knott's Berry Farm is near Halloween, as Knott's Scary Farm is an incredible event which really has some amazing, well done mazes that give great scares, and of course you get to ride the coasters at night, which is also really awesome. When I think of theme parks that bring in the whole package from great theming, awesome coasters, great food, and some charm, I think of Knott's Berry Farm, and it is definitely a fantastic park. Now, coming in at number 2 is a park that I think will surprise a lot of people, and it is Cedar Point. This park was almost number 1. In fact, I very much was flipping back and forth between this and the number 1 park, but in the end, I just decided that Cedar Point was number 2. This park's coaster collection is actually insane and easily the best of any park I've visited, and probably of any park in the entire world, as Steel Vengeance, Maverick, and Dragster are some of my favorite coasters I've ever ridden. And also Millennium Force, Raptor, Gatekeeper, Gemini, Magnum XL 200, Valraven, Rougarou, Blue Streak, and Iron Dragon are all also very solid coasters. The setting for this park is also beautiful, as Cedar Point is right on Lake Erie, and you get some fantastic views of the lake. on the many lift hills of the coasters at Cedar Point. The food is fine, and the park is also well kept up, and it gives Cedar Point a nice atmosphere. Cedar Point is what I wish Six Flags Magic Mountain was, a park with a world-class coaster collection, but also with a nice atmosphere and some great food options, and it truly is a place like no other. But my number one favorite park that I've ever visited is Hershey Park in Hershey, Pennsylvania. I've only went to this park once, but I do know that everything besides the theming for this park is fantastic. Hershey Park has a terrific coaster collection, with Skyrush and Stormrunner being the headliners for the coaster collection, and Fahrenheit, Lightning Racer, Great Bear, and Comet are great supporting coasters to add with the collection. The food here is also very good. With the Smokehouse Restaurant, it has some of the best food I've had at any amusement park. The atmosphere is very nice and charming, and the operations were great when I was there, even though there were low crowds and rain. The only knock I would have against Hershey is that some of the staff looked a bit bored the day I went, and that is it. I enjoyed Hershey so much, and that is even though I never got to visit Zoo America, which I've heard is a nice place to go to get away from the crowds on a busy day. Better yet, Hershey is always looking at how to improve their own park by adding something new every year, which is a bit unusual for an independent park, and in 2020, Hershey will receive an expansion called Hershey's Chocolate Town, which will include a much larger entrance, which looks fantastic, and a new area to the park that will include a new B&M Hypercoaster, which will be another quality addition to the coaster lineup. I definitely will head back to Hershey one day, as it currently is my favorite park I've been able to visit, and I absolutely cannot wait to come back. So, what are your favorite amusement parks? Tell me below in the comments, and I'd also like to know what you guys would like to see me do for my next list. Thank you all for watching, and make sure to subscribe and come back next time here for another video on Coaster Hour.